Snakes, and like amber when it is warmed by crossed into Britain and began to settle in the north of the island. Since the Britons were in possession of the south, having no women with them, these Picts asked wives of the Irish, who consented on condition that, when any dispute arose, they should choose a king. This custom continues among the Picts to this day. As time went on, Britain received a third nation, that of the Irish. They migrated from Ireland under their chieftain, Ruda, and by a combination of force and treaty, obtained from the Picts the settlements that they still hold. From the name of this chieftain, they are still encounter. Caesar's cavalry suffered a defeat at the hands of the Britons, and the tribune Labienus was killed in a second battle which involved considerable risk. He put the Britons to flight. His next objective was the Thames, where a vast host of the enemy under Cassobellinus was holding the far bank and had constructed a defence system of sharpened stakes which ran along the bank and underwater across the ford. Traces of these stakes can still be seen, cased in lead and thick as a man's thigh. They were fixed immovably in the riverbed, but they were noticed and avoided by the Romans and the barbarians, unable to resist themselves in the forests and harassed the Romans by frequent fierce sorties. Meanwhile, the strongest city prince of Tripolitania, became 17th emperor from Augustus and ruled 17 years. Harsh by nature, he was engaged in almost constant warfare and ruled the state with courage, but with great difficulty. He was victorious in the grave civil wars that troubled his reign. He was compelled to come to Britain by the desertion of nearly all the other tribes allied to Rome, and after many critical and hard-fought battles, he decided to separate that portion of the island under his control from the remaining unconquered peoples. He did this not with a wall, as some imagine, but with an earthwork, for a wall is built and sad.